Stay in the know and get listed on location. Our GPS is set. The next stop is Midtown Atlanta. Network 125 Television Broadcasting Studio with the cast and crew of Outlife.
This is Outlife on GTV. Woo! Oh,
my
you're watching GTV on location.
Get the fuck out, bitch!
Okay, I
want to
check
that
I'm really not a diva.
Yeah, yes, you are. I hope that's recorded. Is that recorded?
The truth
sure is
now
it's
coming
out.
Out.
We talk about penis size and diva.
We are sitting here with the cast of Outlife, and we're actually now getting ready to talk to the creator, Cayce, guest. So, how did this beautiful story come about?
It came about, I was working on Vampire Diaries, mm-hmm. season 2,
right.
And I wanted to pitch a reality show,
okay.
And couldn't get enough people to sign on, mm. So I decided to turn it into scripted drama, and hired Tonina Kelly and Amber DeVos and dot, 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 and then this was made.
Right, right. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about the first time that you saw this thing coming to, well, you're established already in the industry.
A little bit, yes.
Yeah, you've done some stuff, and what did you do for the diary?
I just did a lot of featured extra role on television, and I did American Idol 5 years ago.
Which, that's not a bad thing.
No,
it's
not.
You know, there's a lot of people that wish to even get to the stepping stones up.
Right, so I've been blessed so far with small roles.
Is that where you wanted to go? Was it acting, and then it turned into...
I actually wanted to do Broadway,
mm-hmm.
really, and I did one Broadway show, and then actually realized it wasn't what I wanted to do. And then got into acting, and film and theater and movies was actually where I wanted to do more acting than on Broadway Live.
So this idea, was this something that was in you for a while?
Bits
and
really.
Pieces, no?
Mm-hmm. No, I was I don't know, I was actually drunk when I wrote it for Tonina.
Well,
can I say that? Can
yeah,
I say
sure
drunk?
You can.
It was a one-time thing. I was drunk just once. And then okay. I kind of like wrote okay. it out.
You said you wrote it out, right? Wrote it right out.
And she kind of built it from there.
So when you saw it for the first time, how does that feel? To see
what,
this thing
trailer
came from
or
here.
Like,
the trailer. Or even, let's go a little bit deeper than that. The first time that they said action on that day that you were filming to do this.
I don't even remember the first day. Miranda was so nervous. I was talking to Sade, and we rode together that first morning, and I could not believe that we were about to start shooting. It was kind of like surreal, the 40 hours that we shot that first day.
Wow. The first day?
Yeah, I'm just kidding. I was really like 39.
39 and a half.
Yeah. But no, it was very surreal to actually see it coming up. We actually did a table read, and that was the first time I really saw everything come to life besides, of course, the audition. So
let's talk a little bit about the characters from your aspect.
Mm-hmm.
Did you know some of the people that you brought in to play these roles, or was it something where you were like just seeing certain people and going, I think that might be the person?
For the audition?
Right.
I knew Jason before,
mm-hmm.
and I asked him to actually come in and audition.
Mm-hmm.
I knew Sebastian, and I knew Sade before. I've known Sade for like a billion years.
Okay.
So we've kind of been Sarah and Jay for the past 90 years anyways. And then Sebastian, I was lucky enough to meet him and brought him aboard. And I saw Heidi at the audition. That long, long, long day of auditions. And we fell in love with her. She knew that she had to be Lydia instantly.
So, from your aspect of it, what is now the next golden plan now that the red carpet has gone away into the night?
For to turn on the TV and be like, hey, this is Cayce Guest, you're watching Outlife here on Logo.
Ah, so was that a nice little pitch for her?
It was.
But what if MTV wanted to pick it up?
I would say no, I'm just kidding. No, I mean, wherever we're picked up, we'll
right.
be happy with that.
Totally
what do you see in 5 years from now after broadcasting?
Well, hopefully we'll be starting season 6.
There you go.
I mean, all of us to be established actors. I mean, we have such a talented cast,
mm-hmm.
and I know that just the first season is going to blow everybody up to
yeah.
mega stardom, and then I have to bring them all back down. Right. So I'm ready for that. I'm ready to be the bitch that has to bring everybody's head back down. But in 5 years, we're an established TV show that people are actually tuning in to watch every night, every day, whatever it is, in English, Spanish.
Right. Do you would you like the cult following of such as Queer as Folks?
I would love that, because of course I watched Queer as Folks all five seasons. I was a diehard Queer as Folks fan.
Right.
And it's actually what made me come out as a gay man, was Queer as Folks. So
really,
that's what I'm hoping for our show, that we give people confidence to be who they are, not just homosexual, bisexual, heterosexual, whatever you want to do. So
well, talking on that level, you actually have a drag queen that's part of the focus of the show.
Yes. Well, she's one of the featured cast members, and we love her. We love Stacey.
Yeah, and she looks like she's quite a character.
She's definitely a character.
But I mean, I salute you, because it's not an easy path that you're going on. And it, you know, even though there's very many things that are sort of the same, this is taking on its own look and form as its own beast,
right?
We need to call it, because like I said to you when we were talking prior to this, that it's a young cast, it's a pop culture cast. Right. I mean, most of the other shows that we saw were more older or established people, or the other people were just cast members, where this looks like it really focuses on each individual character in the friendship of a whole being.
Right.
And whether straight, gay, which I think is also a great thing, because it's funny that people think because he's gay, they can't hang out together, because she's not, she can't hang out with her.
Right.
When the core of being friends is just having things that we feel that we combine. We understand about each other and having fun with each other, instead of, well, how do I... And I'll pose this question to everyone as we continue doing these interviews. Now that you've been a part of your character and you've done this, and we're getting to the point of signage, what happens when your girlfriend or boyfriend looks at you in question because of a partnership?
Well, my role and my other half role, Nate, the character, is actually a true life, my story.
Okay.
Between, you know, the physical abuse, mental abuse, and the interracial part of it also.
Right.
So that to me is just watching myself on screen, and I'm currently single. So I actually have to answer to nobody. So.
And that's a beautiful thing.
It is a beautiful thing.
Are we going to expect to see other projects as this project is being launched from you, or we're going to focus on this first before? Because, I mean, if you can do this, then that means I can just imagine when you get that production deal and how much more can come out of it.
You mean like other projects for me specifically?
Well, with you know, different stories that are coming out. Right. Like a production company of different aspects of all of this that we're doing. Because, I mean, I see this can branch off in many different ways, for even rooted shows, for other stars branching out on their own.
Right. Well, I know that our production company is actually working on other projects that kind of tie into this outlife type of thing. One of the singers that we had on the series, Crystal Lee Monroe, is actually doing her own reality show.
Oh, okay.
Thanks to Outlife and the production for that. So it is branching off into other projects that tie into some way Outlife, which is like the home base of Cave Production.
That's what's up. We've got a lot more coming up. You are live and direct with me, Danilo Ignacio, and some of the cast members of Outlife. We're not done yet. You'll meet some of the other people. We've got red carpets. We've got behind the scenes. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
This is Gay TV on location.
From the red carpet to an up-close and personal conversation about this controversial new sitcom with the cast and crew of Outlife,